The truth is, most golf videos, most golf articles, they're put together for the older golfer. But the fact is, not everybody who golfs is old. So today we're talking about the five best tips. Yes, five tips specifically for the young golfer. So if you're a young golfer yourself, or maybe you're a parent who's got a young golfer in your life and you want to help them play better, you've come to the right place. I'm PGA teaching professional Todd Cole, Director of Instruction for US Golf TV and the Sanford Power Golf Academy. And for 25 years, we at the Academy here have really focused on developing young golfers. And I put together today five ideas, five tips that we're going to talk about, and a bonus tip here at the end that I know are going to help you play better golf, whether you're a young golfer yourself, or maybe you're a parent who has a young golfer in your life. Now, if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to our channel and be sure to leave a comment. I do my best to respond to all those comments. Maybe you have some ideas that has helped a young golfer in your life play better golf. We love hearing from you and we love the dialogue back and forth. So let's dive right into it. What are these things? What are the five things that I can do? All right, so number one, we're talking about practice tips. Now, I don't think I should need to start this video with saying you need to practice to get better. But more commonly what I see is I see young golfers who they spend a lot of time at the golf course and they actually like to practice, but they don't practice the right thing. So what should they be practicing? Well, hopefully this is not a video about technique. Hopefully maybe you're getting some instruction. We've got a ton of videos on instruction and grip and how to stand that maybe have helped you, but maybe you've got a coach you're working with. But what are the areas of the game that a young golfer should be practicing? So number one, I'm gonna write down here, my favorite is chipping. I would definitely be spending some time working on your chipping because chipping is a skill that requires a lot of time because it's touch and feel. And when we're young, we've got a lot of time. So we can really practice on that. So I would say number one would be chipping. Number two would be putting. I would spend a lot of time working on my putting, all right? And this, I think, really kind of goes without saying, but the short game, as a young person, you gotta learn that. If you learn how to have a good short game when you're young, okay, then you'll have that your whole life. Now, why do I think practicing the short game is more important than practicing the full swing? Well, the full swing is important, all right? Learning how to hold the club and the grip and things like that. And on that line, one of the things I tell all of my parents who have kids in our academy is that the most important information a young golfer gets is the first information, all right? I'm gonna repeat that. The most important information a young golfer gets is the first information, because if they get good information early, their progress is on a nice steady incline and they get better. So, but the golf swing is an evolving thing. It changes. Kids are this tall, and then the next summer they're this tall, and then they start filling out and they get bigger and stronger. So their golf swing is gonna naturally change because their body is changing. But if they get good information early on simple concepts like how to hold the club, how to stand, their swing is gonna develop really well. But the short game is just something that takes a lot of time, and when they're young, they should be doing that. So that would be tip number one. Make sure you get in there and you're practicing your short game. All right, number two, you can't talk to any young golfer without talking about the driver, right? They love to go to the driving range and hit drivers, and you know what? I'm okay with that. That's one of the reasons they love to play the game is they can hit the long ball or try to outdrive their buddies. But here's a couple things I want you to be aware of, because this is probably maybe a little, I don't want to say controversial, but it's different than you might normally hear. I like them to try to hit their driver hard, okay? Well, let me rephrase that. I use the word I shouldn't use. I want them to have some speed. I want them to swing the club quickly. I don't want them to try to hit the ball hard. Okay, a lot of golfers try to hit the ball hard. I want speed because when you're a young golfer, that's when you should be learning speed, all right? It's very difficult to teach speed as we get older. So when they're a young golfer, let them stand up there, let them rip it, as long as the one contingent is they gotta be in balance. All right, they gotta be in balance. Now, a nice tip for that, I'm gonna give you a little bit of tip here, okay, for this, is that when they finish their swing, a young golfer, when you finish your swing, your knees should be touching, okay? We've done some great videos on balance and things like that, but the knees should be touching. So you can swing, if you were my student, you can swing the club as fast as you wanna swing it, as long as when you finish your swing, your knees are touching and you're in balance. And the faster you can swing it, the better. So tip number two, don't let somebody tell you to slow your swing down.
swing it quick, especially with the driver, do it early, be in balance, get your knees touching. All right, next one, course management numbers. This is number three, course management. This is my favorite one for parents, because as a parent myself, you're watching kids play golf and you see them do things on the golf course that, I mean, they'll make you want to pull your hair out, right? Because they're just making some mistakes. This is part of growing. It's part of being a young golfer. It's part of to learn to play the game. So here's one tip that you can give them, and you've heard it 1,000 times, all right? But it's simply aim for the middle of the green, all right? If that's all that you did as a young golfer, or you gave the advice on course management, say, hey, don't even aim at the pin, unless it's like a 100-yard shot, right? Just aim for the middle of the green, because when they aim for the middle of the green, that gives them much more margin for error. The most common mistake I see with young golfers, the easiest way for them to improve their score with their course management is just to get them in the habit of aiming for the middle of the green. Now, this can be challenging, but if they do that, I guarantee you they're going to see their scores come down and they're going to start actually getting some better results on the golf course. That'll be all right. Number three. Number four, proper evaluation. This is a big one for us here at the Academy. We want our students to do a proper evaluation at the end of their day, whether that was a good day or a bad day. That's one thing I didn't even talk about, I didn't even plan on talking about, but I want to mention, when do we do most of our evaluation? After we had a bad day. That's the natural reaction as humans. Didn't shoot the score I wanted to. I get in the car, I'm evaluating, what did I do wrong? All of these types of things. We're going to talk about that in a second. But also when you have a good day, you should also get in the car and think, okay, God, I really like how the way the day went. What did I do? What was my warm-up like? What was my thought process? Some of these other things we're going to talk about. Did I get enough sleep the night before? What are some of the things that I did? Did I aim for the middle of the green? These types of things. Those are key components. So when you play well, make sure you do an evaluation, all right? And if you play bad, you're probably already doing that. But what are some of the stats? Okay, what are some of the stats? Well, I think you should be looking at how many putts you have. That's a basic one. How many greens you're hitting in regulation, all right? You know, and how many should you be shooting for as a goal? It's going to really be based on your average score and what you're shooting, but I would do how many greens I'm hitting, how many putts I have, how many up and downs I get, okay? And then the other one I would keep track of is not fairways hit, but drives that are good enough, all right? Drives that are good enough. What do I mean by that? Because every course is different. Some fairways are really big, some are really narrow. But the stat that I have my students keep is, are your drives good enough? Meaning, after the drive, did the ball come to rest in a place that was good enough for me to advance the ball to where I need to? And sometimes that's, if it's in the rough, but I can get to the green, that's good enough. All right, if it's maybe didn't really hit it real solid and it's in the fairway, but I can get to the green, that's good enough. All right, and the reason that's important is because if you can keep the ball in play, obviously you have a better chance of scoring. So let me give you a quick example, then we're going to move into these couple other ones, because this is an important factor that's good enough. One golfer hits 12 out of 14 fairways, but they hit two of their drives out of bounds. Okay, they've hit 12 fairways, but two of them are out of bounds. The next golfer, all right, hits 10 fairways, all right, but the other four were good enough, all right? The guy who hit 10 fairways but had four drives that were good enough is probably scoring better than the golfer who hit 12 fairways, more fairways, but the other two went out of bounds. So that's a great one, a great tip that I would recommend. All right, let's keep moving along here. All right, number five, performance. Performance, all right. This is a key one here in terms of what should you be evaluating after the round. So one of the things that I like to tell my students is make sure that you're having good positive thoughts when you're on the golf course. All right, golf is a game that beats you up. It can really beat you up. And you don't have a coach with you like you do in basketball and other sports where they can kind of come over and talk to you. So your performance state, your mind frame has to be in a state of, hey, I can do this. So it's very key here that you're positive. Now, this tip is not just for the young golfer, but it's also for us who are watching the young golfer, all right? Make sure that you're positive. Now, that doesn't mean you want to be naive, but in the moment when you're playing around a golf and if the kid looks over at you or you happen to make eye contact with them, be positive. Make sure you're aware of your body language, your head is up, your shoulders are back. These types of things are very important when it comes to playing good golf. All right, now, hopefully some of that stuff you like there. We're going to talk here a little bit about what's the one question that you should be asking yourself on the first tee. But if you've got some comments on these, maybe you like something that I said or maybe you disagree with something I said, that's okay. But go ahead and leave that in the comments because I love hearing from you back and forth. So let's go here with what's the one question you should be asking yourself when you get to the first tee. And here's the question that all of my best players ask themselves is, what's the one swing thought I need to have today to give myself the best chance to have a good day? And we just simply call that clarity. And we talk a lot about that here at the Golf Academy. Clarity. What I mean by that is when you're standing there and you're getting ready to hit that first tee ball, you've got to have clarity in your head of what's the one swing thought I need to have today to give myself the best chance to be successful. The mistake that a lot of golfers make is, and then it leads into their performance here, is they've got three or four things they're thinking about as they're trying to swing the golf club. That just does not work. You got to have good, clear clarity. You got to have one thought. So I don't care if you're a young golfer. I don't care if you're an old golfer. But next time you head to the golf course, here's some ideas, here's some concepts that I know if you do them, will start helping you play better golf.